Hi guys, welcome to today's video. I'm really pleased to share this watch with you. It was kindly sent, hence you saw the paid promotion thing. I was excited to review it because I haven't seen many watches that are A, 36mm and B, going to have good specification to match at this kind of price. So I think it all kind of marries together quite well, but it's not a perfect watch by any means, and I'm going to analyse that and discuss it with you guys in a moment. But the next thing after this waffly intro is going to be the stats and specs. So here it is, guys. I'm going to get straight in with discussing with you what I could think of as suggestions for improvements on this piece, because it's good to get those things out of the way. Then we can move on to all the other stuff, which is going to be what I like about this piece. And then I'm going to show you on a few alternate straps, which obviously I sell. Got to get a bit of promo in there as best I can, because it always helps. And so let's start with that. So my suggestions would be this crown is 5mm. If we're paying homage to the vintage watches of old, I mean, I'm talking about Omega 6B542s, which are issued to the RAF pilots. Then you got Smith's W10 military, things like that. Watches of that era, that were this style of watch, they had a much larger crown. This has got a dinky little 5mm crown. They could have put a much larger crown on here. That's my first suggestion. Secondly, this is the NH38 movement, which has the no date option. So when you unscrew the crown, which is nice, screw down action, you've got one pull and that's it, and it has hacking. I would have liked it to potentially, instead of having an NH38, if they could be really quirky and pay tribute to those watches of old, which were all manual wind movements, this would have been cool if they had a manual wind movement in. But at this price and at this size, those kind of movements are available, often very cheap Seagull movements. So I think that's the better compromise would be to cope with an NH38, which is a great movement. And while we're actually talking about the movement, I had to regulate this movement, and I'm actually going to discuss that with you now, because unfortunately didn't show you its before, but it was running at like plus 20, which for me is a little bit too fast. So what I did was I undid the case back, and then I put it in my time grapher, and you could see the beat error and the rate that was incorrect, and it just needed to be tweaked a bit. So what I did was I used a little tiny, very sharp pointed stick, which I'd sharpened down, very carefully nudged the regulator arm, which you're seeing in this B-roll footage. And there's the plus and a minus. We're talking about not even pushing it. It's almost just touching it is enough sometimes to regulate it enough. You could be so gentle, just gently poke it very gently. And then just keep an eye on the time grapher, how it changes, and then just leave it when it's a good rate. So that's what I did. I prefer a brush case on here, to be honest. This is a lovely bead blasted case. But again, if we're going to keep with looking very similar to the watches of old, they didn't have this kind of finish. I would have liked all brush finish. And the people that sell these watches, Octopus Kraken Store, Baltony watches, for example, they have exquisite brushing. And the flip side of that is I really do like this bead blasted finish, and it's something different. So again, this is why it's not just a clone or anything. They're doing some little tweaks, hence that dial color as well. That's another thing I'll discuss a bit later on. I would have liked, they've got Arabics all the way around here, but I think to help break this up a bit, and we've got this military arrow, which is kind of a lie, because this isn't a military issue watch, but it's paying tribute to them. Just to give some more angles on the dial, I would have liked a triangle at the 12, and then maybe a little logo for the brand underneath that as well, just to give it a bit of balance with the dial again. But again, I'm being really picky, but I think it looks nice as it is, but that would have been nice little design details I could imagine would have really improved it a bit. And then the height of the watch, excluding the extra thickness you get from this double pass here underneath, which is good, it's quite thin. It's a bit of a cheap NATO, but we can live with it. I've actually put some leather treatment or a cream on it, and that's really just helped give it a bit of a sheen. It was a bit dull before, but it was okay. It's totally fine. It's actually really comfortable. But then it adds a bit of height to the watch. But as you see on wrist, it doesn't actually make it look too high. It makes you think it's going to be too high because of all the extra material. But because the way it conforms around the wrist, it fits really well. So it's a bit of a deception there. I can't find much else other than that to criticise. So that's a real positive. The likes I'm going to talk about now, guys, because they are a little bit more than the dislikes or suggestions, which hence is going to make me basically tell you this is a positive review. The essence of vintage military is what I like about this piece. We've got this train track, mini track going around here. Very nice. Big Arabics going around. Legibility. Contrasting with the white arrow you get on there, which is a symbol for British military issue watches. The white of that works really well with the white on the hands. It just looks really smart. The affordability is really good. I like the fact it's about £160 all in, including taxes shipped over. I think, yes, it's not a cheap watch. Nearer to 100 would be nice, but you are paying for really good build quality and a good spec. As you saw in the stats and specs, this is a lovely dome bit of sapphire with clear AR. And you know, and you've got a Seiko automatic movement in there, fantastic loom. These are all things that add up to the specification, but it's on the cusp of being a bit too expensive. We like this green dial, and again, it's emerald green, something different. It's not just black all the time. It's got a lovely sheen to it. It's not sunburst. It's just got a lovely bit of depth to it. It's a beautiful shade of green. Works really well with this faux patina on the Arabics. The white that you get in the train track, mini track, and the hands contrasts again beautifully with that dial. And then you have this tan strap, and tan works really well again in harmony with this earthy tone of the dial. So it just works together as a good looking piece without being too garish. The size and weight is so refreshing to have something with these vintage dimensions. 36mm is a great size. It's so wearable. It doesn't feel too small because you've got a lovely big dial. That's what the surprising thing is about small watches. As long as you've got a big dial, it doesn't look like a tiny little watch, because the dial size on this is about 1mm different to a 40mm sized dive watch. It's extremely legible, so clear and easy to read. And that is aided by what is sensational loom. The loom is really good. I mean, even though it's applied these indices, they just obviously really loaded it in there, obviously put a bit of dye to give it this faux patina color, and it is a good grade of loom, I must say. It really does glow nicely. Got reliable movement, although it wasn't obviously regulated when I got it, but it is a good solid movement. Boring but really rugged. Good power reserve. It's got a fairly smooth sweep. It does the job, and it's perfect for this type of watch. There's one thing I forgot to mention that is actually a negative. Watch the dial as I hand wind it. It's difficult to see on the camera, but it's got a slight bit of wiggle. Literally, is like the movement inside is not gripping tight enough inside the case. It never wobbles. You never notice it. It never looks like it's shifting about or doesn't feel loose or anything like that. There's obviously a tiny, tiny tolerance difference in the way the movement is pushed in into the case. So what they've done is between the movement and then the screw down case back, there is a spacer ring. It's a white ring. So I can imagine the idea of that is when you screw the case back in, pushes against this white spacer ring that's on top of the standard one that's built into the movement. And that sort of squeezes it all together. So you don't notice anything wrong until you just maybe hand wind the movement occasionally. Oh, another thing I remembered now, God, it's all coming back to me now, is this finish, as great as it is, and that's, like I said, I would have suggested a brush finish. The downside to it is if you ever get nicks in it, you can't actually brush them out like you can in a brush finish watch, because you can actually quite successfully get rid of scratch marks in brush stainless steel by using a scotch pad to follow the lines of the brushing, and actually you can get out minor scratches and things like that, but you can't do that with this finish. So it's going to not wear as well as the brush finish watches. And a high polish one, like the original pieces from that era, would have maybe made this look a bit too bling, in my opinion. I like this more subdued look. It almost looks like titanium. So I think I've covered everything that you need to know. But you know what you're going to need to do if you don't fancy wearing on this strap is change it out. So here's some alternatives. Sticking with the military theme, here we have, from my store, the Field Marshal. This is a beautiful NATO. It's not too thick. And I'm going to get it on wrist to show you how well this army green works with that dial. And it's just going for the full green effect. Here is on wrist, super comfortable. Doesn't have much height to the watch off your wrist. As you can see, it's not bad at all. Really nice. And that green actually matches it perfectly. Well, like, let's get another option on. And here is the Crazy Horse saddle leather. This ages so beautifully. You get the lovely color distortions. It just ages in and it's so soft. You can see here how well this earthy tone, just like on the original NATO it came with, just works with that green dial. They just complement each other really nicely. And you've got this cream stitching working with that faux patina you get with the Arabics. So marriage made in heaven. Let's try another strap. Here we have a brand new release. depends when I release this video. I don't think I've even managed to get it on the store yet because it takes so long. This is a vintage style strap, already got a distressed look to it. It's still very soft, but it's got this lovely cracked effect to it. So it's got a bit of padding as well. Really nice, soft, genuine leather. This is such a nice addition to watches that have this kind of vintage look. Just got one more just for luck, because I think it's a bit early, but I've got a festive theme that I could suggest to you guys, which I think could look really exciting. Again, another brand new release with nice padding. Managed to source an extra premium grade of leather. This is so buttery smooth with perfect stitching, lovely contrasting red stitching underneath. And this red, I think, what a perfect combination for the winter time, autumnal changes, definitely Christmas. You've got green and you got red. Harmony. I just think this is so fun and gorgeous, but I'm obviously biased because it's me. So if you've enjoyed this video, please check out some of my other playlists. I've got an amalgamation of other content. If you fancy continuing your YouTube journey with this channel, that would be much appreciated. Just click one of the links and I'll look forward to seeing you in another video or the next one. Bye for now.